Good morning. We'll talk today about Parkinson's disease, and this disease will affect around 1 to 2% of individuals who are 65 years old or older. The disease is being characterized by destruction of the dopaminergic cells. If there was a destruction of the dopaminergic cells, this will lead to a deficiency in dopamine in the nerve terminals of the striatum in the forebrain. The dopamine deficiency can lead for a major motor symptoms of the disease, but also we can see loss of noradrenergic nerve terminals, italy reduction of norepinephrine. Italy we will see common non-motor features in the Parkinson's disease, including fatigue, abnormality in blood pressure regulation. What are the symptoms that can be seen for the disease? These symptoms or signs will start gradually after age of 50 with a slow progression. He could suffer from mask like blank expression, stupid posture, tremors, bradykinesia, and muscle rigidity. And of course, when he suffers from such symptoms, he could suffer from mental deterioration and a depression. This disease rarely occurs in black population, and since the deficiency in dopamine, we are concerned to know how dopamine is being synthesized. Dopamine is being synthesized from tyrosine and through enzyme called tyrosine hydroxylase. We'll add a hydroxy group to the tyrosine to get a DOPA. This DOPA will be decarboxylated by decarboxylase enzyme to get the dopamine. And depending on the type of the cell, or if you are in the periphery or the central nervous system, we could have dopamine hydroxylase enzyme to get noradrenaline, and the noradrenaline can be converted to adrenaline on through adding a methyl group by enzyme called N-methyltransferase. At the same time, dopamine is being metabolized by MAO enzyme through deamination to get this structure, 3,4-dihydroxyphenylacetic acid, or the COMT enzyme will add a methyl group to the one of the ketones hydroxy to get 3-methoxytyramine. Either this or this, the end products of the metabolism will be homovanillic acids, لأن الإنزيم اللي هيشتغل هون هيشتغل هون once again, and the vice versa صحيح. كمان مرة الدوبامين جبناه من التايروسين. التايروسين حيصير له hydroxylation by tyrosine hydroxylate to get the levodopa. The levodopa will be decarboxylated to get the dopamine as a neurotransmitter. The etiology of the disease is unknown, and sometimes they relate in the disease sababo proteolytic stress, genetic mutation, environmental or endogenous neurotoxins, mitochondrial dysfunction, and oxidative metabolism. So they advise our patient to take antioxidant vitamin E in order to slow the progression of neurodegeneration with Parkinson's disease. How can we treat the Parkinson's disease? I have deficiency in dopamine, so I can make augmentation for the synthesis of the brain dopamine, stimulated dopamine release, direct stimulation of the dopamine receptor, decrease the reuptake of dopamine, or decrease the dopamine catabolism. For our treatment, it could be dopaminergic therapy, okay, to reduce motor symptoms, or we can rely on anticholinergic therapy that will not give us a high relief of symptoms. Dopaminergic therapy will be divided into dopamine replacement therapy, dopamine releasing agent, dopamine receptor agonist, or a dopamine dopamine enzyme that will inhibit the metabolism of the dopamine. Dopamine replacement therapy, we can't replace dopamine from extraneous source for many reasons. Among them, that dopamine, if we give it externally, will not access the central nervous system from the periphery. لأنه my drug, my neurotransmitter is hydrophilic, ionizable. It will be ionizable at physiological pH, so it will not penetrate the blood-brain barrier. The second thing, I have two types of enzymes that can metabolize my drug, COMT and MAO. So they will not be available in a good amount. Also, when I give it externally, my drug can bind to different types of receptors, among them norepinephrine, serotonin, and dopamine. So we'll see many side effects in the central and peripheral nervous system. فشو الحل؟ الحل إنه I can give it give the precursor of dopamine which is the L-dopa. ليه L-dopa؟ لأنه it can access the CNS عن طريق amino acid transporter less basic than the dopamine, and I have abundant enzymes decarboxylase enzyme that can convert the dopa to dopamine. But we have to know that we have dopa decarboxylase enzyme in the periphery as well. فمشان نمنع تحويل الدوبا للدوبامين in the periphery losing part of our drug, we give الكاربيدوبا اللي هو عبارة عن decarboxylase enzyme inhibitor اللي هيمنع تحويل الدوبا لدوبامين in the periphery. بالتالي I can't lose part of my dose بالperiphery كمان, ما راح تظهر عندي side effects نتيجة البينding of dopamine to receptors in the periphery. And في عنا product بالماركت اسمه سيرمنت. This one عبارة عن one part of carbidopa اللي هو decarboxylase inhibitor with 10 parts of levodopa. البيوسينثيسيس كمان مرة الالدوبا حكينا يتصنع من التيروسين and it will be converted لدوبامين and will be metabolized لهوموفانيليك اسيد. pyridoxine هو عبارة عن coenzyme for dopa decarboxylase يشجع decarboxylation of الالدوبا لدوبامين بالperiphery, بالتالي I will lose my drug. So when we give الكاربيدوبا بالتالي تأثير البايروكسين would not be that high. هلا ارتفع عنا الدوبامين in the CNS. This can sometimes lead to non-motor signs, among them of side effects the psychiatric disturbances such as visual hallucination, mania, hypersexuality, paranoid psychosis, and نتيجة what stimulation of dopamine receptor outside the motor striatum for the patient. ميزات الليفوتوبا كمان انه it is can be absorbed from the small bowel, peak plasma will occur after 2 hours, and the problem is my drug is affected by presence of food. كمان يعتمد على rate of gastric emptying, the pH of gastric juice as well, and presence of enzyme that can degrade my drug. Again, my drug will be metabolized by the liver to homovanillic acid. The second type of treatment will be the MAO-B inhibitor. Why did we choose the MAO-B inhibitor? لأنه A is being found in the intestine, بالتالي it will prevent the metabolism of certain compound that can lead to side effects. زي ذكرنا previously في عنا cheese effect. Okay, cheese أو الألبان they contain a tyramine, which is similar in structure to neurotransmitter. And if this one is not being metabolized by MAO-A enzyme, will bind the different receptors, leading to cardiovascular stimulant activity, to hypertension, and etc. But we prefer to have MAO-B inhibitor. فبالتالي these MAO-B being found in the brain. بالتالي if we block the MAO-B enzyme, will prevent the metabolism of dopamine. And the example here is the selegiline. وهو نوع it is a proper غيلامين type selective inhibitor, irreversible inhibitor for the MAO enzyme. As you can see, this is the selegiline, propylguilamine, small 1,2,3 propyl amino compound. This part is a phenyl, شايفين. Okay, this is phenyl 1,2 bridge amino. فاحنا شنو عن مشابهين في dopamine, and we are adding propyl side chain. Propylene, لأنه it is a triple bond. This either selegiline أو الدواء الشبيه فيه هو رازيجلين. Both of them they can form tight binding to the enzyme by forming irreversible binding blocking for that enzyme. Okay. We can take the MAO-B inhibitor مع levodopa in order to reduce the metabolism of the dopamine, having longer activity for the drug. And كمان من فوائده it will prevent formation of neurotoxic oxidation product of dopamine and slow degeneration in Parkinson's disease. We have selegiline, rasiglene, they go extensive hepatic metabolism. And they can lead to cardiovascular, the orthostatic hypertension, and psychiatric hallucination as a side effects. The COMT inhibitors that will prevent the metabolism of the L-dopa, we have tolcapone and entacapone, and both of them they are nitrocatechol in their structure, and they have a good affinity for the active sites of COMT enzyme. أما الأسيتوفينون moiety will make antagonistic action. They can form tight binding for the COMT enzyme. Let's see the structure. Karna, they are nitrocatechol structure in their structure, and tolcapone has a long duration of action in the periphery and in the brain. And كمان مرة نتيجة ارتفاع الدوبامين نتيجة prevention of the metabolism of dopamine, my patient could suffer from nausea, vivid dreams, confusion, and hallucination. Sometimes my patient could suffer from hepatic failure. ليه hepatic failure؟ إذا فاكرين we are having a nitro attached to a benzene ring. This will lead to a liver damage لأنه حيصير في عنا uncoupling of mitochondrial oxidative phosphorylation, reducing cellular generation of ATP, and this can lead to cytotoxic pro-oxidant radical formation in the hepatocytes. Also, the COMT inhibitor can lead to severe diarrhea, produce increased dyskinesis for my patient. The third choice إني أنا أعتمد على agent that enhance the release of the dopamine or prevent reuptake in the same time. But we have amantadine and memantine, and both of them drug we used them previously as antiviral drug for influenza, to treat influenza. They promote release of dopamine from the intraneuronal storage sites and prevent dopamine reuptake. This is the structure of amantadine and memantine. It has an amino group. It is ionizable, high pKa. لكن my drug بالرغم من ذلك كان access to the brain because it is a cage-like hydrocarbon structure. فبالتالي it will confer lack of velocity for the structure and it can penetrate to the CNS. مشكلة my drugs here in home, they depend on the presence of dopamine in presynaptic stores. ما في عندي stored dopamine, they will not be effective in the treatment. The fourth choice, إني أنا أستخدم dopamine receptor agonist, and this type of treatment بزبطه في حالات late stage disease during levodopa therapy. فمشكلتنا بالdopamine agonist, they are non-selective, فش عندي balance between D1 and D2 receptor using for treatment, and they can be found as مميز فيهم, they are long duration of action compared to levodopa. And they are less likely than levodopa to induce on-off effects of dyskinesis. I have different drugs in this category. I have ergot derivatives and non-ergot. The non-ergot I have framapixol and propinerol. And كمان مرة لأنهم they bind similar actions. The dopamine they can produce nausea, vomiting, sedation, hallucination, and other different type of other psychiatric imbalance. These agonists, I can give them in combination with levodopa or carbidopa, or they can be given as monotherapy في حالة إنه my patient is young and can tolerate side effects. The ergot derivative, we brought them from grain fungus. Okay, it is alkaloidal products. We have a chromocryptine with pergolide. If we look at their structure, we have a benzene ring, we have a 1,2 ethyl bridge and amino group, similar for dopamine, so they can bind to its receptor. Chromocryptine, it is ergot peptide. Okay, since it is a peptide, it will be metabolized 90% of the dose after oral administration. Okay, so the half-life will be very short. The chromocryptine is known to be taken at low doses, effective prolactin inhibitor. At higher doses, it will be used for treatment of Parkinson and mood elevating effects for it. Pergolide, it is a non-peptide, but the half-life will be longer, and it is effective at D1 and D2 receptor zayo as compared to chromocryptine, and can be given orally. This table is showing us different types of agonists having different affinity to different types of the dopamine receptor. Also, we can see side effects can be seen for norepinephrine and serotonin receptors as well. We will come back to propinerol and pamixol. Propinerol, as you can see, it is indole derivative and unrelated to the structure of ergolin. High affinity to D2 receptor and can be given orally. Pamixol is tetrahydrobenzthiazole derivative. Can be given orally. It is D2 receptor agonist as well. and has a low oxidation potential. بالتالي it can work as scavenger dopamine derived free radicals and electrophiles. Okay. Finally, we will from the agonist class, sorry, we have an apomorphine. This apomorphine is highly related in structure to dopamine. As you can see, this is the benzene 2 hydroxy group, bridge 1-2, then anhydride amino. It is oriented in a specific orientation and it still can bind the dopamine receptor, but that it can work as anti-Parkinson drug. Also, it works as emetic agent. This drug has a pKa around 9, still it can cross the blood-brain barrier, unlike the dopamine. The odd apomorphine is potent D1-D2 agonist, and it can produce anti-Parkinson effect equivalent to levodopa. LS يشتغل as postsynaptic D2 type antagonist and presynaptic D2 type autoreceptor agonist, autoregulation. The why I can't give it orally, because first pass metabolism حيصير له metabolism عالي كمان and a potent emetic effect. Okay, for the only way to give my patient, I give it as sub-Q injection في حالات late stages Parkinson disease. وزي ما انتم شايفين similarity, عملنا superimpose for both of them, it can be superimposed over the dopamine. The second choice of treatment حكينا, I have to use sometimes anticholinergic, antihistaminergic drug, and this type of treatment ينجح only في أو حصلني around 20% improvement in the symptoms of the disease. كمان الانتيستامين drug that have CNS anticholinergic activity can be used as well. فالidea scientists discuss it that if I can restore balance between acetylcholine and the dopamine, I can relieve the symptoms of the Parkinson's disease for my patient and improve his signs and symptoms of the disease. These are different drugs that can be used in Parkinson's disease belonging as acetylcholine, anticholinergic, sorry, anticholinergic drugs and antihistamine drug as well. We will discuss them later inshallah when we talk about the antihistamine and the anticholinergic system. Best regards.
Good morning. Parkinson disease. Parkinson disease affecting approximately 1 to 2% of individuals who are 65 years old or older.